Book 7 of the Aeneid, Aeneas and his fleet sail again and reach the Tiber River. Upon landing, the Trojans feast, using dried-out wheat cakes for plates. Jupiter prompts them to devour these cakes after eating. Wait a minute. This fulfills the prophecy that they will eat their platters! Aeneas praises the gods and makes offerings to them, and Jupiter sends thunder and a fiery cloud. These are good omens that the men have reached their destination. Latium's king, Latinus, has only one child, a daughter named Lavinia. But neighboring King Turnus wants to marry her, although prophecies indicate she will marry a stranger, one whose lifeblood will lift our name to the stars. Aeneas starts building a town and sends a delegation to King Latinus, who receives them in a hall that echoes the power and history of Italy. Latinus recalls that Dardanus, one of the fathers of Troy, originated in Italy. The Trojans offer gifts and pledge friendship, and Latinus offers his daughter to Aeneas to fulfill the prophecy. Meanwhile, frustrated she cannot change Aeneas' fate, Juno vows to make life miserable for him. She sends Alecto, the Fury of Rage, to start a war. Driven insane by rage, Lavinia's mother whisks her daughter away and whips the mothers of Latium into a frenzy. Alecto then visits Turnus in a dream and corrupts his heart with anger. Finally, Alecto causes Ascanius to inadvertently start a bloody battle with Latin citizens. Torn between his pledge to Aeneas and the anger of his people and Turnus, Latinus refuses to lead. He will not open the gates of war, so Juno does it herself. Armies from all over Italy gather to support Turnus. At the beginning of Book 7, Virgil again calls on the Muses to help him tell of the war Aeneas must fight to claim his fate in Italy, the history of Rome. In an interesting interplay of the will of the gods, Jupiter fulfills the dire-sounding prophecy that a great hunger will make the Trojans eat their platters. But in a harmless way, their platters are wheat cakes, and this great hunger is for their new home in Italy, rather than from a physical famine. Also, representing Virgil's typical sympathy for both sides, Turnus does not seem naturally war-crazy. He initially refuses to respond to Alecto's goading, but eventually, he's infected by her rage. Opening the gates of war symbolizes that the country is at war, but here, they function literally, not symbolically. Juno opening the gates of war actually causes war to break out.